All right, here's a quick video on the Uniden Bearcat BC. Well, I mean, you know how to read. I bought this off of eBay for under 40 bucks. Did some searching online. And there's a modification to make it have about 80 channels of memory instead of 30. I don't recommend doing this. If you're going to do something like this, do it at your own risk. Be aware of all of your current laws and regulations regarding radios. Modifying radios in your area may be illegal. I'm licensed. I know a little bit what I'm doing here. So, don't do this, is what I'm saying. But this is how I'm doing it. So, let me show you. Turn it on. It's got some presets in already. Actually, I'm still figuring out how to use this. Okay, there we go. 30. It has 30 presets. So, to get started, first I want to remove these two screws. Well, I'm going to remove these two screws. And then, let's see how this has come off. Yeah, there we go. Remove these two screws. And I'll remove the batteries, and I'll continue the video after that. So with those four screws removed, this cover simply comes right off. And here you have one of the boards. Looks like this does some of the not signal processing, audio. Looks like an audio amplifier here. Some voltage regulation. This is the RF side of the board, it looks like. I've literally had this thing out of the box for maybe 10 minutes, and I went, hey, let's make a video. So, it is ideal to do this on a ESD mat. I'm lacking that right now, but I'm good anyways. So, this board here lifts straight up. There's, I think, 12, 14 pins right here. That hold it in place, and this whole thing should take the antenna off. Okay, so I was doing it wrong. This just lifts up and pulls away. Look at the solder job on this. So this one, I dated 1996. That's good. In my case, these radios, if it's made before 2000, this modification will work. If it's made in 2000, it's a little bit different. I'm not putting up instructions on how to do that or how it is done. This is for radios made before 2000. So next step is to remove these four screws, which I will do now. Alright, I have the ground shield off. This looks like it's the digital signal processor memory. This is the brain box of the whole thing. So basically, you just solder bridge. So there's number one. That's your, that's like a landmark on the board. Underneath is a trace here. Goes through cap and resistor, and then here is the ground plane or ground. You just put a solder bridge across here, take a piece of wire, cut it real short, and solder it across here. So radios made in 2000, you do this one, and then there would be another spot that you do the same thing to. And when you do that, it also takes away a certain frequency range. I think it's low band. Go into do an online search on that and you'll see what I'm talking about. So basically I'm just going to put a solder bridge right here. I will put the radio back together and see if I actually get 80 channels of memory as I'm trying to do. Anyways, there's the jumper. I made just a thin piece of stranded copper wire, tinned, soldered across. Moment of truth. Was I lied to by the internet? Oh man, what a question. Okay, preset one. Let's see. see, what has it got? There we go. 80. Yep. It went from 30 to 80. It does work. I don't know if I lost any bands. I'm assuming no. If I do, I will make a follow-up video. Yeah. Holy shit, it... it works. Sweet. Anyways, thanks for watching. This video is way too long for what it actually is. This would have taken me, like, maybe 3 minutes to do if I wasn't recording. Anyways, be good.